You came back. So that everybody got mad at me.
Joke. He's up, folks. It's you too.
And anyway, newsflash. A Gibson Les Paul that plays like ass. Like that's never happened. So what is going on with this guitar? As I've been informed, I don't have a pick, but it probably doesn't matter. It really just chokes out. Here. We don't like that kind. So, this is something that happens. Sort of a common ass type of a thing where this portion of the fretboard, where all the body joint and everything is, slightly rising up. Not by a lot, but by enough to choke out all the higher frets. I will get the straight edge thing and attempt to photographize that exact situation.
Imagine. I realize you guys will probably never see this, and I really haven't checked to see if the truss rod works, but the neck relief is really close. But what happens is when I put this notch straight edge on and I look at the very end of the neck, the space gets bigger and bigger and bigger. It shouldn't really be like that, and I can almost, you know, even with my shitty bifocals, see where things just sort of rise up in this area. So that's what it's going to get. We're going to do the full level crown polish thing. There's lots of fret there to do it with. We're not going to take much off. The frets are all in really good shape, but that's what's going on. That's why we're G string's really bad. Yeah, like you can hear that? We don't like that kind. Alrighty, boys and girls, that's about it. It's, you know, it's almost summer, so it's time to just start doing some spring cleaning. That's the way things work around here. It's just like, man, oh man. What am I gonna do? Oh, we're gonna spin down the other end and just deal with the neck straightness before I even pull the strings off, just to make sure the truss rod and everything works the way it's supposed to work. Otherwise, it's sort of game over. And as always, I hope everybody's enjoying life, having as much fun as humanly possible with the resources you have at hand. When I was a kid, it was a stick and a mud puddle. Somehow we got by. What am I looking for? The magical wrench. Over here in one of the many drawers. It's going to be a new segment. Yeah, it's going to be called What's in Dave's Toolbox. We're going to look in each drawer one at a time. Looks like somebody's ratted this over a bit, but needless to say, there we go. Let's just try a little loosening first. Okay, it just seems to work nice and smooth. And as always, on a Gibson guitar, the truss rod is way more responsive than a Fender bolt-on. I don't care to understand the mechanics behind that, but all I know is you end up turning a Fender truss rod more than you do a Gibson to get some adjustment out of it. So I'll lay down here like a Goomba. Like I said, somebody sort of, I don't want to use the bad word, you know, a quarter turn on a Gibson guitar. Okay. I'm going to get a new angle here.
I lied, it's the same angle. Anyway, the truss rod works wonderfully.
and I'll just re-straighten the neck. Once I get the strings off it, you guys know this drill.
Yeah, so I'm down here like a gremlin with the notched straight edge. And I'm looking for a light. So what's going on, as you, I can see it here. Maybe I can get the camera over and show this. What's actually happening is what I said. There's unevenness here where the neck meets the body, and this dial looks flat. What I'm doing here is I'm literally adjusting the truss rod and watching the gap of light leave the straight edge. And yeah, so that's too far. Perfection is sometimes very difficult to achieve, but we need to make the neck itself as straight as possibly can, and I'm gonna quit there. I don't think I can get a camera in here to show this. A little bit more maybe? No, then she starts to hump up in the middle. Right there, that's the sweet spot. That's as good as it's gonna get. All right, let's tape off and other things that we do with, end with the letter off, and carry on.
What the hell, now you get to see my ugly pumpkin. But what's going on here is now I've got the wood part as straight as I can get it. But when we put this guy on top of the frets, now we see that right around the body joint, I can see light, which means there's a dip here, and these end frets are sitting just high enough to make all that stuff choke out. Like I can almost get a rock out of the straight edge. Unreal. Okay, now you know.
Special shout out to China for creating the biggest, fattest, greasiest blue marker that money could buy at the dollar store.
Okay, today's leveling is going to be done with a radius block. Just why? Because I have it. A leveling beam is very versatile because it will follow the radius of any guitar and you can do a lot more work with it. But sometimes if you have the radius block, it's a good choice. And I did take the nut off this end. Radio then. We'll just get a little. I'm going to move the camera, hold on to your chair, tighten up your seatbelt, so you can just sort of see what I'm talking about. The beam's taking nice stuff off here, and then all of a sudden everything gets sky high at that end of the world. We're going to get rid of that. We now have a rocking set of flats. Good for nothing. We need to crown them. I'm going to put blue on them again just so I can see the crowns. See how nice it works out, you know, with a million reflections and all kinds of things going on. You can actually see the tiny little bit of blue left at the top, which is the crown. Give me 30 minutes. There you go. It's a whole new day. Look, I got a new shirt on.
And I've been polishing and polishing, and now I'm at the end of it. And just while I'm shooting the breeze here, I posted a video on my Facebook community for all those who go there. Today's World of Fun Stuff, Facebook. It's a little video about the resurrection of the Elma Combo Club here in Toronto. The famed Elma Combo Club. And my old friend Greg Godovitz is involved there with Mr. Wackerly, who's got way too much money. But anyway, check out the video and what these guys are doing. Oh yeah, Eddie Kramer's down there too. We couldn't find anybody qualified to deal with the technical aspects, so we just went and got Eddie Kramer. If you don't know who Eddie Kramer is, well, you can just sort of look him up. He's worked with a few little bands over the years. Okay, so now I'm polishing these by hand, right? You're watching me do this. You see all that shit that comes off of there? So I see the guys do it with the little Dremel wheel, and it's real cute, and I'm sure it's fast. I'm sure it does a nice job, but all the first time the wheel spins around, well, you just keep spinning that around, don't you? So that's why you sort of gotta, you see, after I rub it with the polish, then I gotta take a clean piece of the rag and wipe it again, right? So observe, right? A little bit of that guy on there. And then when I rub the fret, that's what comes off. Isn't that wild? And then we take another little clean piece, rub it again. Anyway, I did the thing with the tape. I know every guys would put the tape on it. Yeah, put the tape on the edge. I did. I'll demonstrate, hopefully, how well or not well that works. I've had varied results, hit and miss, so to speak. Look at those guys. Woohoo! Woohoo! Yeah, it's gonna play like a Les Paul now. Okay, let's do the do. You notice I've got the hand condoms on just because I don't like wrecking my fingers because they're destroyed. I've got so many heavy calluses and scars on the end of my fingers. When I start doing really tight work and twisting and torquing the end, the callus is all split, and I got one scar here on my thumb. It just wants to keep opening up over the years. Hey, someone's calling. Maybe they like me. That was Michael from the duct cleaning service. I informed him that I only have chickens, no ducks, and they're all clean. All right. Let us peel this crap off of here. Yeah, I think it's going to play like a Les Paul. I did notice one thing, though, too, when I removed the nut. Someone's replaced it with one of those Tusk guys. And the bridge has been changed at one point in time. And the slots for the strings, all it's there, like no one's really cut those. All that's there is the little groove that they give you to start you off so you know where the center of the thing is. So we might do a little bit of adjustment there. Okay, so I'm doing the thing here, guys. I'm finding that piece of tape that I put on the edge. I'm pulling at it. And well, so far, oopsie, it broke. Come on, Dave, you can do it. Yeah. Fun times. Hey, this is always the fun part, the nice reveal after you. Yeah, see, it has to break there because it does. Start at this end and see what happens. Here it comes. Here it comes. Oh, it wants to break. I guess. You notice I'm still, like if these were just all pieces and I was working my way along, I'd have peeled those off. Instead, I'm working my way along the neck on one piece of tape. I don't think it really makes a lot of difference. But because this guitar had the bindings, like it does, I taped the very edges like that anyway, just to protectulate all the good stuff. see, it broke again. All right. You can do it. You can do it. We can do it. Hey, look at that. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. It's looking pretty nice. Okay, I'm gonna pause. I'll come back. Okay. Give me a couple minutes to string it up. Like I said, these have never been touched. I don't like to carve these too much. You can play with the string height a bit by cutting these slots deeper. The heavier strings just need to be opened up a little bit, I think, but if the strings are staying in, I'm just going to string it up, see what's going on, and put the nut back on it. And go from there. So I'll come back in a few minutes. Hey, it's all tuned up to bitch. Clean up a couple of things here that I don't need right now. And let's just set the neck relief. And see what's going on with that. I don't need it plugged in for that. So, let's just see what's going on. And of course, because I've straightened the hell out of the neck, it's way too straight. Well, that's okay. A little lefty-loosey. That's about a quarter turn. Like I said, give us the guitars. Like, maybe it's, I was thinking about it, maybe it's because it's a shorter neck. So it takes, I don't know if that makes any mechanical sense whatsoever. Okay, so that's a beautiful 12th thou. It really is. Yeah. Rock it. Let's see what the string height has to say for itself. Yeah, so remember from... all that chokiness... gone. Sit for a couple hours because I had all the strings off it and everything for a while, and I'll just go through the whole setup again and see what the intonation for the nation has to say and all that good stuff, folks. You know, it is a Les Paul. Oh, what I did want to do, I just want to look at each individual string height here. So the E is where it should be. Yeah. Oh, nice. Okay, I quit for an hour or two anyway. And then we'll look at it again. Till next time, folks. Cheers. Thanks for all the support. Stay tuned. I'll be back soon. Bye now.